Hey everyone, in this episode of 5 Minutes Astronomy, I'll discuss the question, why is Venus's motion so weird? Venus is the second planet orbiting the Sun, the hottest in our solar system, and is also called the Earth's twin. But today, we will not talk about its volcanoes or hellish environment or any possibilities of life there, but the way it moves. Every planet rotates on its axis while also revolving around the Sun in an orbit. So does Venus. What makes it stand apart is that unlike most planets, Venus shows retrograde motion, that is, rotates east to west. Another way of putting that is Venus's axis is flipped at an angle of 180 degrees. In terms of revolution, Venus's orbit stands out for being the most circular of all the planets, with an eccentricity of just 0.007. An eccentricity of 0 means it's a circle, and between 0 and 1 means it's an ellipse. To add to this, the rotation of Venus is so slow that it takes it more time to rotate than to finish an orbit around the Sun. Let's understand why this happens, one weird motion at a time. Starting with rotation. Most planets rotate in the same direction as their host star because they form from the same nebula. There are two possible reasons why Venus rotates opposite to most planets: a collision or tidal forces. It is possible that during its formation, proto-Venus had a collision with another proto-planet which flipped its spin axis. But a more accepted theory is of the tidal forces. As Venus orbits the Sun, there is more pull on the side closer to the Sun than on the side away from it, because of which Venus bulges towards the Sun. Similar tidal forces on Earth due to the Sun and the Moon are responsible for tides and hence the name. In terrestrial planets with thick atmosphere, like Venus, the action of tidal forces can significantly make the planet lose angular momentum and hence rotate slower. This, combined with the friction between the core and the mantle, explains further loss of rotational energy as heat. These would also cause the spin axis to become oblique up to 180 degrees. But models have shown that this is more probable if Venus had a higher obliquity of its spin axis to begin with. A study showed that it is also possible that instead of the axis flipping to create opposite motion, it is also possible that the Venus was prograde, but the combined forces and torques slowed it down to still and further to retrograde motion. The same study showed that the two possible stable modes for rotation in each direction, with the ones in retrograde to be more stable for Venus, and hence it was just a matter of time for Venus to rotate in retrograde. The initial large obliquity may have resulted from a collision or some complex gravitational play. The long rotation and its retrograde nature also creates for a weird day and night cycle. While one rotation on Venus is 243 Earth days long, the day and night cycle corresponding to sunrise and sunset is approximately 114 Earth days long. Absurd? Well, we define a day and night cycle the same as rotation on Earth because the duration for both are almost the same. But there is a technical difference. Day and night cycle is the time taken for the Sun to return to the meridian over a location on a planet after setting and rising. Rotation of planets, in the other hand, is measured with respect to distant stars and is the period the same side of the planet takes to face the reference star. For Earth, it is 23 hours 56 minutes. It is also called sidereal day. But during this time, our planet has moved a distance in its orbit, and hence the Earth, which rotates in the same direction as it revolves, has to rotate a little bit more for the Sun to be back over the meridian of the reference location. This takes an extra 4 minutes, and hence the solar day is 24 hours. In the case of Venus, owing to retrograde motion, Venus rotates in the opposite direction to its revolution, and hence the apparent movement of the Sun is faster compared to distant stars. So within a sidereal day, that is one rotation on Venus, one can experience two solar days. The next puzzle to solve is Venus's strangely circular orbit. Kepler showed that orbits of all planets are elliptical with the Sun at the focus. Circle is a special ellipse with major axis equal to the minor axis. The degree of elliptical nature is measured by eccentricity. The Earth has an eccentricity of 0.0164. Pluto, which has a very eccentric orbit, has an eccentricity of 0.244. The shape of a planet's orbit is a result of the resulting gravitational forces on it due to the Sun and also of the other objects around it, no matter how small or far. Even the slightest gravitational force from an object far away can cause a noticeable change in a long time. It's hard to say whose gravity caused Venus to have a circular orbit. A two-body diagram in a gravity is easy to solve, but adding more and more components significantly complicates it. Jupiter would have played an important role in shaping the orbits of other planets. Another factor is orbital resonance. When two objects have revolution periods in simple whole number ratios of each other, they are said to be in resonance. Bodies in resonance exert periodic gravitational tugs on each other. Usually these resonances are unstable, and the bigger body will usually force the smaller out of resonance by changing its orbit, and hence eccentricity, often completely removing them from the resonating orbit. Example are the gaps in the Saturn's rings formed due to Saturnian moon's resonance. But in some cases, the resonance can be stable and the orbit settle as such, like in the case of the three Galilean moons of Jupiter, Io, Ganymede and Europa, which have a 1:2:4 resonance. It is possible that earlier Venus was in resonance with Jupiter or other planet which shaped its orbit. Tidal forces on Venus can also affect its orbit. For example, the tidal forces of the moon on Earth is slowly increasing the moon's orbit and slowing Earth's rotation, while also making Earth's orbit more and more circular. Soon, Earth will also have a more circular orbit like Venus has now. It's just a matter of time. In the end, it's wise to say that our understanding of the complex dynamics of history of the solar system is always updating. Science is self-correcting, and in the future, the real history of Venus will become even clearer. Do not forget to like this video and comment below. Share the video with other space nerds and subscribe to the Astro Geek Comics on YouTube and Instagram for more such amazing content. Until next time, stay curious and keep looking up.